past summer, hackers released documents related to 700,000 cops around the United States, which they had scraped from 251 law enforcement websites. This month, a journalist at Mainer magazine went through that leak and found evidence that cops investigating the rioting that happened during Black Lives Matter protests wasted time pursuing people online who were, to use the technical term, shitposting. For instance, the Department of Homeland Security informed local law enforcement personnel that a Sacramento man known as DJ Kirok was a violent opportunist who was inciting people to burn down two sports stadiums in California. What did this guy actually do? Well, it turns out that he was an Oakland Raiders and LA Lakers fan who tweeted during the protests, "Can y'all burn down the 49ers stadium while y'all at it?" And then, "Actually, fuck that. Can you all burn down the Golden One Center?" Those tweets got no reaction from his 200 followers, and they were obviously jokes about his rival sports teams. But the feds decided that it was worth pointing this guy out to local cops as a violent person. The Maynard journalist gives several more examples of really obvious shitposts that federal authorities wasted their time cataloging and then spreading around to each other. On the one hand, it's really funny how cops have zero sense of humor. But on the other hand, it's extremely frustrating that because of that, they're fucking around with shit posters when they could be, say, actually stopping violent alt-right extremists who are literally murdering people. Luckily, I'll point out that at least some FBI agents had their sights set appropriately and just stopped alt-right extremists from literally kidnapping and possibly murdering the governor of Michigan. The Mainer's report comes to us almost concurrently with this fun new study published in Personality and Individual Differences titled "Right-Wing Authoritarians Aren't Very Funny, RWA Personality and Creative Humor Production." But wait, I hear you complain because you're a complainer by nature. Humor is subjective. How can you scientifically evaluate who is funny and who isn't? And even though everyone is frankly sick of your complaining, in this case, you are correct. Much like studies on attractiveness, we need to be super critical of who gets to decide what's pretty and who gets to decide what's funny, because these things can vary across cultures and even within cultures. So this study, like way too much psychological research these days, was performed on American English-speaking college undergrads. I'll say this for them, at least they were racially diverse, considering that only 59% of them were white. So, you know, I'll take what I can get. 186 of these students took surveys to determine their level of authoritarianism, which scientists suss out by asking subjects how much they agree or disagree with statements like "old-fashioned values show the best way to live." They also scored their personalities on how conscientious and open to new experiences they are, since in the past, studies have shown that those specific traits tend to correlate negatively and positively with sense of humor. For the bulk of the study, though, they basically just asked the subjects to be funny, doing things like completing potential joke setups, making up definitions for nonsense word combinations, and captioning single panel cartoons like this. That last one is a trick, since we all know that the funniest caption will always be "Christ, what an asshole," or in a pinch, "Hi, I'd like to add you to my professional network on LinkedIn." Then they had 8 anonymous raters independently score each response with either 0, not funny, 1, kind of funny, or 2, funny. And of course, that's where we run into the issue of how do we decide what's funny? Obviously, it's subjective, but that doesn't mean that we can't note how a large population generally feels about a subjective thing. We can say, for instance, white, heterosexual, cisgender American men in their 50s and 60s tend to rate big asses as attractive. Even if we can't say all men love big asses. But the problem with this study is that we only have 8 people rating the responses, and we don't know anything about those raters. For instance, are they authoritarian themselves? We know from past research that authoritarians tend to find humor in mocking people that they feel are beneath them. The study authors state none of the humor tasks involved common targets of authoritarian aggression, but that doesn't mean that some neo-Nazi can't make a caption for this cartoon that makes the butt of the joke a Jewish or a Black person. So let me say for the record that personally, I do not think a study with only 8 raters that we know nothing about, like their cultural background, how old they are, anything, is rigorous enough for us to make any concrete statements about whether or not right-wing authoritarians are funny. But I will say that as a preliminary study, this has legs, since they did find a strong, significant result that showed people who scored higher on right-wing authoritarianism were extremely unfunny. A significant result was still found even when controlling for conscientiousness and openness to new experiences, suggesting that right-wing authoritarianism itself is connected in some way to a lack of sense of humor. I'd love to see something like this expanded upon, and you could easily get more raters using the Mechanical Turk or some other system. So please, let's get on this, scientists. Finally, science can tell us if Dennis Miller is so unfunny because he's now a right-wing authoritarian, or if he was actually just never funny to begin with. It's important stuff. We need to get to the bottom of this for the sake of our society.